Chemistry has transformed the late night happenings of your bedroom, so we put together a list of 4 sexual innovations provided by chemistry. Condoms or rubbers or whatever else you want to call them, now these are a brilliant way to stop pregnancy at the source. They're cheap, they're reliable, and they protect you from not-so-sexy STDs. Most of you out there probably know that a majority of condoms are made out of a stretchy polymer called latex. Polymers are large molecules that are made up of chains of smaller molecules called monomers. In the case of latex, the monomer is isoprene. When used properly, condoms do a great job stopping these little guys from reaching their final destination. Now, when using condoms, it's always wise to have a bottle of lube nearby to smooth things out a little bit. Too much friction can break a condom, which give these guys free rein. Lubes come in a handful of forms, some water-based, some oil-based, and some silicone-based. At the surface level, all lubricants work the same way on any two surfaces that happen to be rubbing together. When two solid surfaces rub together, they have tons of super small imperfections that create friction. When a lubricant is applied, it produces a film between these two solid layers and removes immediate contact from the two imperfect surfaces, which smooth things out quite well. But be careful, folks. The use of oil-based lubricants can lead to breakage in condoms because petroleum-based products will eat latex. There's also some additives that go into lube that give them certain sensations like warming. Simulating a sense of warmth on the skin is called thermoception. In most warming lubricants, glycerol is the main ingredient as it helps aid the ingredients that cause the heating sensation. Some warming lubes even contain capsaicin, a molecule found in hot peppers, bringing a whole new meaning to the phrase spice up your sex life. Okay, so look, safe sex is always the way to go, but then there's also Plan B, the morning after pill. This controversial form of emergency contraceptive has led to a wide range of debate in society, but we'll leave that aside for now and just get right into the chemistry of how it works. Plan B is actually a dose of a synthetic hormone called levonorgestrel. This hormone binds to the same protein receptors as other sex hormones like estradiol and progesterone, which aid in making women fertile. But instead, levonorgestrel interrupts ovulation or impairs the fertilization of egg cells. It is also thought that Plan B might stop an already fertilized egg from adhering to the uterine inner wall, preventing embryonic development. Chemist Carl Gerasi was a forerunner of birth control in the 1950s. Gerasi developed the first orally deliverable version of progestin, a primary ingredient in all birth control methods. Progestin is the synthetic form of the body's hormone progesterone. When combined with estrogen, these hormones can control a woman's ovulation cycle and prevent egg release. What's really remarkable about the birth control pill is that it revolutionized the way that people get it on when it was approved by the FDA in the early 1960s. Gerasi's innovation in chemistry completely reconfigured the way that society thinks about sex. Check out this bonus video of a sexy chemistry poem written and recited by none other than Carl Gerasi himself, who happens to be a well-accomplished published poet. Believe me, it's incredible. And thanks for tuning in, folks. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you again soon.